So we're here today at Hoo Zoo and Dinosaur World in Telford, UK. I'm so excited to see what animals they have here. Come on, let's go.
D-O-D-I, it's Codi.
We're about to go inside and meet two amazing wolves called Tala, who is a Eurasian wolf, and Lycan, who is a wolf-dog hybrid. I'm so excited. Come on, let's go. Howl! Lycan. Hey, Lycan. How are you? Look at his big tongue. Lycan. Hi, Lycan. Ah, beautiful. Look at his colours. He's gorgeous. So, Will, can you tell me about the wolves?
Yeah, so we've got two wolves in here. Well, one who isn't actually a wolf. He's a wolf dog. So he's a little bit different. That's Lycan, who's this big guy over here. And then we've got a Eurasian wolf as well, who is right behind us, just over there, and her name is Tala.
So where are they from then? Can you tell me a bit about wolves?
Yeah, so Eurasian wolves come from Europe, so places like Russia and Poland and all sorts of over there, and into parts of Asia as well, hence the name Eurasian. It means they come from both. So they're also found in parts of China and Mongolia.
Wow. How old is Lycan?
Lycan's about 10 years old now, so he's getting to be a bit of an old boy.
Hi!
Yeah, good boy. Yeah, he's starting to get a little bit of an old boy now, whereas Tala, his girlfriend, she's a lot younger than him. She's about 5.
Aww. Do they get on? Are they good friends?
Yeah, they get on very, very well. Yeah, they we don't have any problem with them living together. They're both very, very happy living together.
Oh, they're so cute. And what do they eat, Will?
So in the wild, they'd eat all sorts of different things. Wolves, a lot of people think that wolves only eat meat, which is sort of true, but they would also sometimes eat berries and things like that. They're actually omnivores, so they eat both meat and fruit and veg as well, but a very, very little amount of fruit and veg.
Wow.
So in the wild, they might eat all sorts of things like, you know, other little fluffy animals, but yeah, mostly in captivity, we just feed them on sort of a nice bits of bacon and things like that.
So they have a really healthy diet then, with some fruit and vegetables and meat.
When they sometimes eat the berries and stuff like that, yeah, they do. They have a very very healthy and very mixed diet.
Wow. And do they sleep in the day or the night or a bit of both?
A bit of both, but they are more active at night. In the wild, particularly, they would be pretty much solely, so pretty much all the time, active at night, so they would be nocturnal. In captivity though, they tend to be awake a bit more during the day, because that's when they know that we're about.
Wow. And they're really friendly. They like humans. They're letting us come into their house and play.
Yeah, they're both very, very friendly. Lycan particularly, before he came to us, he was used for lots of TV work and stuff like that, so he's very, very used to people. Whereas Tala's a bit more shy, but yeah, they both like people a lot.
Oh, that's great. Thank you for letting me see the wolves today, Will.
That's no problem at all.
We're about to meet the slender-tailed meerkats. I'm so excited. Come on, let's go. Oh, you like my socks? Hello. Would you like some corn? Hello. Hi, little fella. Meerkats like to eat insects, but will also eat other things such as eggs, plants, spiders, and lizards. They like to live in groups of about 50. That's a big family. So we're here at the ringtail lemur enclosure. Let's go and have a look at them. Is that tasty? Mmm. Hi. Got twins, two little babies. Ringtail lemurs like to be in groups of about 30 and huddle together to keep warm, like one big hug. They also like to lie in the nice warm sun. Ringtail lemurs only use their tail for balance. They don't use it to swing from. These marmosets are small, long-tailed South American monkeys. They eat insects, fruit, and tree sap. They like climbing trees and moving really fast from branch to branch. Let's go and explore Dinosaur World. Come on, let's go. This is a pterodactyl. Pterodactyl. Can you say it with me? Pterodactyl. They had a wingspan of 30 metres. That's the same size as a London double-decker bus. Wow. Let's go and find the next dinosaur. Come on, come and have a look. Is a Dimetrodon. Can you say it with me? Dimetrodon. They use their sails, the bony spine on its back, to help keep warm by soaking up the sun during the daytime and then get rid of the heat at night. Can you see it? Come on, let's go and find the next one. This dinosaur here is Postosuchus. Can you say it? Postosuchus. They were crocodile-like species with long snouts and lots of sharp teeth. They could gallop, similar to a horse, using all four legs. So these three guys here are called Hararosaurus. Can you say that? Hararosaurus. They were one of the first ever dinosaurs. They had strong claws on their hands to make it easier to grasp its food, also known as its prey. Let's go and find the next dinosaur. Come on! This dinosaur here is called an Allosaurus. Can you say it with me? Allosaurus. The meaning of this name was different lizard. We've also got Stegosaurus here. Can you say it? Stegosaurus. They had 17 plates or spines along their back and down their tails. Can you see them? Have a look. Quick, let's go and find the next dinosaurs. Let's go. Dinosaur was called an Allosaurus. Can you say it? Allosaurus. They were herbivores, which means they like eating plants. Useful to reach the top of trees with that long, tall neck. Let's go and find the next dinosaur. This is a Triceratops. Can you say it? Triceratops. The meaning of Triceratops is three-horned face. They use their horns to protect themselves. Can you see them? This dinosaur is a Tyrannosaurus rex. Can you say it? Tyrannosaurus rex, or T-Rex for short. They had 50 to 60 teeth, each one the size of bananas. They were very clever, with brains twice the size of other giant dinosaurs. I hope you had a great time with me at Who Zoo and Dinosaur World. Wasn't it fun? Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos. See you soon. Bye.